Hello guys, welcome to online digital marketing training. In this video, I'm going to explain. So here is a scenario. One of my students have a domain in this GoDaddy account. Okay. And she has another GoDaddy account. This is another GoDaddy account. Here we have a Ultimax Linux hosting. In a hosting, there is an option called web hosting. I'm going to show you that. So when you want to take a hosting, there are two hostings. One is WordPress hosting, one is web hosting. If you want to maintain only one website, then go for a WordPress hosting. This will cost you around 3,500 rupees. Where you will be having a one domain and hosting for 1 year. This is, but you're planning more websites in the future. Other time you have to invest again 3,500 more rupees. This is waste. Other time go for a web hosting. You want to start an agency or else you have many startup ideas, go for web hosting. Here there are two plans again, deluxe and ultimate. So go for ultimate anyway. Expensive, nearly 8,000 to 10,000 rupees it will be there. But what you'll be getting is unlimited domains you can host. You have to pay for a domain only, not for the hosting again, and you'll be getting SSL certificate for the main domain. The only difference between both of them is SSL certificate they're only giving anyway. So the difference is 2,000 to 3,000 only. It's better, I suggest go for this. So she has selected that hosting only, Ultimate Linux hosting. Now she can have multiple domains placed here, but make sure that the domain should be there in this GoDaddy account only, but her domain is in another GoDaddy account. Now how to manage, I'm going to tell you now. So with a WordPress hosting, you don't get a cPanel here in a GoDaddy I'm talking about, but here with a web hosting, you'll be going to the cPanel where you make the changes. This is the cPanel anyway. Okay. You can see this, every server have an IP address. So this is the IP address. Copy it. Come back here. And when it comes to this is the different domain again. This is the different GoDaddy account. So this is the ID. And when it comes to here, this is a different GoDaddy account. Both are different. Now here, come back to the domain which you want to host there. They'll be having a DNS. DNS means domain name servers. See, as of now, she bought a domain, but she didn't host it anywhere. That's why it's showing parked. It's not pointing to anything. Assume that in this GoDaddy account, if you already hosted, this will have some value. Then you can change it anyway. Now what I'm doing, I'm clicking on edits, points to this address, whatever I've copied. There I have to push it, this address. Talk to that and save. Now it means like this domain is ready to get hosted in that GoDaddy account. It's done. Now, what is the domain name? faeb.in. Come back here. You have to add this domain in this account. Add on domain. faeb.in. I added the domain. Soon it will be available. After that, I'm going to install a WordPress in this. Sometimes it may take 24 hours. Sometimes within 5 minutes only, your website will be ready. Okay. So the video which I'm explaining is you have two GoDaddy accounts and one GoDaddy account you have a hosting and domain is in another GoDaddy account. Now at the time, how to make that domain over here. Even if you want, you can transfer that domain from here to there. At the time you have to call GoDaddy people. They will transfer it anyway, but no need to transfer both of yours account only. So simply if you do this, it's enough. it's taking some time anyway. And later I'll also explain you how to create subdomains for your main account. See guys, subdomains you can't create for all the domains. When you're taking a hosting, ultimate Linux hosting, when you're taking, your main domain will be there, root domain will be there. On the root domain, see, as of now, your primary domain is fifthavenueeventmanagement.com. For this only, you can create a subdomain. Done. Adam domain is done. Now, you can install things. The difference between a WordPress hosting and web hosting is, WordPress hosting, by default, WordPress is installed. But here, apart from WordPress, you can install Joomla, Drupal, Magento. Things. Now, I'm installing WordPress now. Where I'm installing the WordPress? On which domain? faeb.in I'm installing anyway. So by default, see guys, this is very important. By default, it is asking me to install a WordPress on a main domain. As of now, I don't want main domain. I want to it in a faeb.in. See, faeb.in. Again, you have two versions, HTTP FAB or HTTP www. Go for www. Sometimes here it will be like a blog. Remove it. There should be nothing. Then create an administration username and password for WordPress. This is. And give your email address. Okay. Which on which domain you want to install WordPress? This should be nothing. You have to erase it. Give your username and password and your email address. Then install. Now WordPress will be getting installed on this domain. Now we successfully pointed that domain to this GoDaddy account and we added the domain and we're installing it. So I'm telling you, if you have two GoDaddy account, what you have to first go to your first GoDaddy account. And take the server ID. Second, go for another GoDaddy account. Select the domain and change DNS. Third, go to first GoDaddy account. cPanel, select add on domain and add this domain. Fourth, install WordPress in this on this domain. That's it. Now see, I installed WordPress here. Website is ready. faeb.in. It's done already. Within 5 minutes only, it is done. Now you can happily you can create a website in this. Now you want to create a subdomains. How to create subdomains again? So scroll down here, add on domain here, subdomain. You can create a subdomain here. See guys, if you have a website, n number of subdomains, you can create it. So they're giving an option. I don't know whether it will work or not. Let me try. Actually, on a root domain only can create a subdomain, but they're giving an option. Let me try anyway, if it is coming. I'm selecting like, caps. Now her main domain is faeb.in, caps.faeb.in. I'm creating a subdomain on that. Done. Now again I'm installing a WordPress. Here install this application. Where I have to install? You have to select this drop down. See caps dot here you should not select www. Subdomains will not carry www. HTTP caps dot faeb dot in. I have to remove this. If not, your blog, your website will be created under this domain. So don't do this. Now username. Now I'm installing it. Now I created one subdomain. I'm installing a WordPress on that. Let's see. I never tried subdomain on the another domain, add-on domain. First time I'm trying. Let's see if it works or not. Generally, subdomains work on the root domain. Let's see whether it is happening or not. Since it's happening. How to create subdomains. cPanel, select subdomain, create subdomain, third, install WordPress. That's it. Yes, guys, I've installed it. Let's see if it's working or not. Yes, it's not working. So on add-on domain, it's not working anyway, but on a main domain, it will work anyway. Let's see anyway, sometimes it may take time. That's what I'm trying. First time I'm trying this anyway, but subdomain will work on the main domain only, not on the add-on domain. It's not working. But on a main domain, we can happily work it. Okay. Thank you very much, guys. If you have any questions, put a comment so that I'll be replying back to you. And if you're looking for online course or e-learning, visit my website www.odmt.in and put a request. Thank you very much.